Hi guys, I'm Joe Hildreth and welcome to My Heat. So this is probably the first video I've ever shot out in my shop, and you guys know what it looks like out here, so this is quite a feat to get enough space to do this, but here we are, and I hung up a little shop porn, you know, just to make it official. So anyway, look, this is a different video tonight, right? I've had a few people email me pictures of things that they've made in their shop and who subscribe to my channel, and these are projects that I think are of real value and worth taking a look at. So I decided to put a few of my subscribers over some time here in the spot, so or on the spot, so to speak, or in the spotlight, right? So this series is called Subscribers Spotlight, and this is where I just want to showcase a few of the things that some of my subscribers have sent or have made and sent me pictures of that I think are worth sharing. And I'm doing this because I think that I view my channel as more of a community, right? I think that the group of people that subscribe to my channel and other channels like mine are very good people, right? And they share ideas, they share help, they share constructive criticism, all those things that make us, people like me, new machinists, beginning, aspiring machinists, better. And I think they, I think sometimes even the old timers sometimes pick up something or remember something that they forgot about when they go to help people like me. So anyway, tonight's spotlighted subscriber is Steve from Oregon, and Steve made a lathe dial upgrade for his Atlas lathe, and he used mostly the lathe for the project, although he did use his mill a little bit to make the jig for the stamping jig. And if you've seen my videos, you've seen that stamping jig before. My intention is to do the same lathe upgrade and send that jig forward. But anyway, Steve's a lathe dial upgrade is really nice, and I want to share it with everybody else and say, Steve, thank you very, very much for sending those pictures to me. I enjoyed seeing them. I enjoyed to read your descriptions of what you done and what you, how you made it and that sort of stuff, and I think others would benefit. So Steve, thank you. So without any further ado, let's take a look at the pictures.
Steve started the project by turning a piece of stock to 1.75 inches in diameter. He engraved it using a thread cutting tool turned on its side, like you see here in this photo here. To get his indexes, he used Mr. Pete's trick of using a 100-tooth saw blade. So here you see the picture of the saw blade attached to a spindle and a stop set up there to catch on the teeth. To stamp the numbers, Steve had to make a jig. He made this on his mill. Here you see the 3/16 inch stamp in the slot of the jig and the dial inserted in the jig, you know, to hold the stamp straight. Here's a close-up view of the dial in the jig. Now if you look closely, you'll see that there's two little pop marks and the index line is lined up to either of these. In this video, or in this photo, you see that the index mark is lined up on the left pop mark so as to accurately position the number that he's stamping. Here in this case, it's number 0. And in another view, you see that the index mark is moved over to the right to the other pop mark to accurately place the number 3. So this is a pretty nice way to evenly space the numbers and get them on the dial. A little different, he explains, than what Mr. Pete done when he made his dials for the Logan lathe, where he used shims, I think Steve said. In order for Steve to use the new dial that he created, he had to add a spacer to the existing nut on the cross slide. Here you see the spacers on there. He said it was a light press fit or a press fit, but he added a set screw just to ensure that the collar wouldn't move. While Steve was in the mood of making parts, he made a new nut to hold the handle on. This one extends a little further so that you can get a wrench on there and you can make adjustments easier. So here you see Steve holding the nut up here for us to see. And finally, we get to see the new dial in position. I got to admit, this is a nice upgrade. Steve, you've done a great job, and thanks for sharing with me, and thank you for allowing me to share with my other YouTube subscribers. This looks like a great project to do, one I would like to do to my own lathe, because I'm kind of old and blind and can't hardly read the graduations on mine and have to use a magnifier or geezer goggles, as my wife likes to call them, to see it. So, Steve, thanks again, buddy. This is a great addition, an upgrade for the Atlas lathe, and thank you for sharing.
So after seeing that, you got to admit, that's a pretty nice project, which brings me around to projects and the subscriber spotlight. If you've done a project that you don't want to do a YouTube channel, or you don't do a YouTube channel, but you have a project that you've made in your home shop, and you would like to be featured as in the subscriber spotlight, send me pictures of your project and, you know, the machines that you used, and it's a little bit of information about it, and we'll set the details and some emails back and forth. Now, there are two ways that you can email me, and I'll put them up here on the screen. First, you can email me to my personal account at xavier@gtech.com. That's xavier@gtech.com. Or you can email me at youtube@myheap.com. You can email me that way. If you go on my site, you can hit the contact form and you can send me a message from there too. But either way, if you have something that you would like to share with our little community on this channel, please send some pictures and some information and we'll go from there. So other than that, thank you guys so much for all your patience. I know it's been a while since I put a productive video out. I am working on it, and you can see I've gotten more of my shop done. This is this wall was completely just bare studs on the last video I put out, so I've got all but about 4 feet of it done and about 12 feet of the other wall here, and then I'll have it all insulated, at least the walls, and then I need to start in on the ceiling. But again, thank you for your patience. Thank you for taking the time to watch my videos, and thank you for the ongoing support. I mean that from the bottom of my heart. You guys are awesome. You guys are just simply awesome, and I appreciate you. So, other than that, have a blessed day.